Hi there, it's Naomi with Top Shelf VA. Today's Camtasia training video is based on a recent question I received in a comment on one of my past training videos. Greg Perkins asked, in some of the screen recording on Camtasia, you enlarge a section of the screen, but not a zoom. How did you do that? If you have questions, always feel free to ask. Here's the answer to Greg's question, plus a more advanced bonus style pop-out after you know how to do the basics. It is relatively easy to create a pop-out effect. Here is an excerpt clip from my recent video on how to master the Camtasia reflection visual effect. I'll link to that video at the end of this training. Let me go ahead and hide some of this clip on the Canvas portion so it is not confusing for you watching a Camtasia training video of a clip of a Camtasia training video. Okay, the first thing to do is to determine what portion of your video you want to have as a pop-out. There is a large section here where quite a few things will be happening in the Camtasia Properties panel. So for ease of creating this, I will put a beginning marker where I will want to start the pop-out. Shift plus M for the marker. I'll put another marker for the end. These markers are only for placeholders, just in case I have a slip of the finger. I'll now highlight this section with my playhead handles and press Ctrl plus C to copy the section. Then double-click on the playhead at the beginning marker to close the playhead handle brackets. Now Ctrl plus V to paste the copy of that section of the video onto the track above. With the copy selected, either press Shift plus S to silence the audio or right-click the copy and select Silence Audio from the pop-up box. What I like to do is splice the track underneath at the beginning and at the end, as I am going to group this when I have completed the pop-out. It's a nice way to ensure the pop-out stays with the correct section of the video and doesn't get out of sync. Click back on the copy section on the top track. Now either hold your Alt key down to crop or click on the crop icon at the top and crop the top video to the edge of the properties panel. Go to Visual Effects and add the drop shadow. Change the offset, opacity, and blur to zero. What I would suggest is then clicking on the plus sign to save this as a preset. Call it Drop Shadow Pop-Out. You can then add it to your favorites as I have done here. Go back to Visual Effects and add a border effect to the copy track. Change the color to your branding color. Change the thickness to zero. Do the same as you did for the drop shadow. Click on the plus sign to add as a preset called Border Pop-Out. Put your playhead near the beginning of the clip and press Shift plus A to add an animation keyframe. Let me expand the timeline so it is easier to work with. In most cases, I personally like having the animation at 15 frames or half a second. Now move this so it starts at the very beginning of the clip copy. Move your playhead to near the end and do the same thing. Shift plus A to add an animation frame. Adjust it to 15 frames and move it to the very end. With your playhead in the middle of these two animation keyframes, anything we do here with the pop-out will happen as the animation. Let's see how that happens by creating the pop-out. You can create whatever drop shadow you want. I usually use 10 for my offset, opacity at 100%, and blur at 20. I will change my border thickness to 8, then move the pop-out to the left so the border shows on all sides, and expand the pop-out. Now, let's look at the pop-out in action. Put the cursor at the beginning, prior to the animation of the pop-out. Take note of what the properties are for the width, height, drop shadow, and border. Move the cursor to after the animation starts and take note how the parameters have changed to what you set. Now move the playhead to the end of the second animation and see how the parameters went back to the original settings. The last step now is simply to select the pop-out and the bottom track and group them together by pressing Ctrl plus G. Rename it so you know what it is. By grouping these together, they can't get out of sync with each other. Let me guarantee you, this is a lesson I learned the hard way. You can remove the markers at this point. You can also do something similar with a circle annotation, animating it across the canvas using the media mat and the new Camtasia motion path visual effect. Okay, we have our kayaking video, which you may have seen in my previous training video on creating realistic shadows in water. Here, we are going to pop out and magnify this kayaker in the distance. Let's start 2 seconds in. Place a marker here by pressing Shift plus M, then expand and highlight out with the playhead to 20 seconds and place a marker here. Ctrl plus C to copy. Bring the playhead back to the beginning and press Ctrl plus V to place the copy. Split the lower track at the beginning and end of this section that we are going to magnify. Now place a circle annotation over the kayaker and enlarge it a little to include some space around her. You may want to change the opacity so you can see below the annotation. Extend the circle shape annotation the length of the copy clip. Move the playhead forward by a second. Go to Visual Effects and add the Motion Path effect. Place the start point directly over the kayaker. Move the playhead to 1 second away from the end of the copy clip. Move the motion path end point to over the new center location of the kayaker. Extend the motion path on the track to the playhead. Adjust the motion path handle so there is a nice curve from the beginning to the end of the motion path. You may want to bring the playhead to the center of the motion path so you can determine how to create a nice, gentle curve. Now put the opacity of the circle annotation back up to 100%. Add the visual effect media mat to the annotation. We're going to want to add a border to this effect. Duplicate the annotation by pressing Ctrl plus D. With the duplicate highlighted, remove the media mat in the Properties panel. Go to the Annotations Properties tab and change the shape opacity to 0. Change the outline color to a color that is a complement to the video and a thickness of 15 or whatever thickness you choose. Let's group all 3 tracks together, the border, the media mat annotation, and the copy of the clip by pressing Ctrl plus G. We can also remove the markers now. Let's rename this to Kayaker Pop-Out. To make this easier for increasing the size, we want to crop the group, but make sure to only crop so the border circle shows from beginning to end. I'll move the playhead to near the end of the group and crop from there, holding my Alt key down. We don't want the border showing until it expands, so let's go back into the group. Click on the border track and change the opacity to 0. You'll also notice I did not add a shadow for this pop-out, but you always can do so if you want to. Let's add an animation keyframe at the beginning and end of the border annotation. But this time I'm going to keep them at 1 second in length because the video itself is a slow, smooth glide down the river. We don't want or need a fast animation here. With the cursor between the beginning and end annotations, I will put the opacity of the border outline back to 100%. Go back to the main timeline and place a start annotation at the beginning and end of the group. With the cursor between the beginning and end annotations, let's expand the group from the left side. For the simplicity of this training, we'll keep the right side as is, only magnifying and expanding from the left. Now let's see how that looks from start to finish. As you can see, the kayaker is magnified, enlarged on the canvas, and gently follows down the river. This is where you could use a call to action for your viewers, such as don't forget to subscribe and hit that notification bell, or watch one of these videos next, or if you have any questions, leave a comment below and I'll be happy to answer it for you. And until we meet again, have a wonderful day.